Hi, everybody. I'm Lacey Shane. Welcome to Real Women, Real Success. Today, we're going to be talking about why it is that women compete with each other. And I have to tell you, I have been asking myself this question almost my entire life. I had great girlfriends when I was a little girl, but from high school on, I noticed the competitive nature. You know, when boys come into the equation, that's when it all went south. And while I did have some good female friends throughout high school and college and my early adult years, they were really few and far between. I've shared in other videos that early on in my career, I was supported and mentored and sponsored and assisted in my career, always by men, not so much by women until just recently in my career. And I had had an idea or a perspective on why that was. And I think we all know someone that didn't have a great childhood or who's been in an abusive relationship. And with that comes baggage that if folks don't go to therapy and look at how to clean that up in their lives and make it be a part of their past instead of their future, it really drives their behaviors. And I had an idea that it was either baggage or a situation growing up or perhaps self-esteem issues that really made women compete with each other and undercut each other and hurt each other. And I had a very interesting experience recently where I met this wonderful woman that I anticipate we will be great and fast friends for a long time, who is doing leadership training with some very large corporations, has been in the military, a very, very successful woman in the military, and really a woman who supports other women. And we were talking about this issue of women competing, and I was shocked for her to tell me that she said, you know, I used to compete with other women early in my career. And I was shocked by that and taken aback by that. And I asked her, I said, why? Why on earth, you know, would that be the case? And she said, you know, I don't know. I don't know why I did it. And that was fascinating to me. I said, you know what, I'm going to do some research on this because I must know if it's not just baggage, if it's not just insecurity, what more could there be? And I read several things. I came across a wonderful article from the New York Times that's exactly the title of this video, Why Women Compete with Each Other. And I am going to scan it and give you a PDF of that, a copy of it with this video so you can read what I read. It was so, so fascinating. It's an interesting and fast read. But basically what it said is that in the psychology world, there's two theories why women compete with each other. The first one comes from evolutionary psychology, and what it basically says is, if you think about what they say about humans in the caveman era, they just lived instinctually to protect their food, to protect their family and their kids. It's sort of like that. Women just are hardwired to protect themselves, their families, and their womb, basically. So it makes the case that instinctually women are trying to protect their womb. But what I thought was even more interesting is the second theory, which is feminist psychology. And what the feminist psychology says is that women are competing for men's attention, and that this has to do with our mothering instinct and procreating, and that we have to level the playing field so that we will be the most attractive to the man who will impregnate us and allow us to fulfill our female duty of being a mother, which because I've never been that competitive, I had never thought of that. And certainly not every woman is interested in men. So, you know, where does that come into play? But I can kind of see how that instinct might be prevalent in the workplace. And here's why. When you think about who holds the majority of leadership positions in corporations and in organizations, we've already identified it's men. That's why we're all here. That's why Real Women, Real Success exists, is to help women ascend to be a greater percentage of the leadership that's needed today. We need women in these positions, but right now it's dominated by men. And so we do find ourselves in a situation where to advance, we do need the support and accolades of men. And so perhaps this instinctual historical psychology of women, of feminist psychology, perhaps that has some merit when I have someone that I'm so impressed with, a woman that is so accomplished and so successful, say that she used to be competitive and doesn't know why, it sure lends some credibility to the fact that it might be an instinctive psychology that women have. So I throw that out for you to learn from, just as I learned from it. Because when we talk about why do women compete, it may or may not always be a voluntary action or a planned or premeditated action. It might actually be involuntary in some cases, which leads me to how important it is to be self-aware about why we are conducting ourselves the way we are. Why are our behaviors happening? Because if we don't know, at least we're observing something that we want to change, and we can then put steps into place to help create a new behavior that's more productive. So I think we can see that from those two psychological frameworks, anytime we're putting our success or our value in the hands or perspectives or judgments of another person, we're in trouble. We're really in trouble. So I think one of the things that we can do to really, really improve ourselves, if there are any remnants of competitive nature in us, is to focus on ourselves, to focus on personal best, and to come from that mindset of abundance. There's a mindset of abundance and a mindset of scarcity. Abundance comes from the notion that there are plenty of places for everybody who wants to succeed, that we all have our own individual mark, our own unique contributions and value, and that nobody else can be us. So there's room for everybody. And while it's true that when there is a position open and in an organization and there are many people applying for that, of course there's not a position for every person. I understand that. That's elementary. But perhaps there's another opportunity for those who didn't get that one. In fact, not perhaps, I know that there's another opportunity for those that didn't get that position. Have you ever had a situation where you wanted something so badly and it didn't work out, and then later on down the line, you found out why that didn't work out and that it was good for you and that actually something better happened along the way? Those are the kinds of experiences that people have who have a mindset of abundance. A mindset of scarcity says there's a limited number of places at the top and I'm going to scratch and claw my way, and I'm going to compete, and I'm going to level the playing field so that I am the one that gets that position, so that I am the one that gets that recognition. I am the one that gets that relationship. And that is definitely coming from a space of feeling insecure, not sure of ourselves. So if there's any of that in you, and there is in all of us, we all have insecurities, but it's so good to be aware of that and work on it so we can move whenever we're coming from a mindset of scarcity to a mindset of abundance, because that is the mindset for success. So if you see this competitive nature in the workplace and you want to be a force for good, there's some things that you can do. First of all, just be an example of women supporting women. If you have ever engaged in that competitive behavior, see what you can do to sort of knock that out and change your strategy and try to nail down why it is that that might be have been part of your past behavior and what you can do to move forward in a different direction that's more supportive. The other thing that I have done on occasion, and only you can decide when this is appropriate, but is call out other women when they're being competitive. Because sometimes women don't know it, right? Sometimes it's instinctual, it's just a behavior that we haven't questioned or really honed in on. But here is something to help you look for this kind of behavior. It's not so blatant sometimes as a hateful act or a jealous act. Sometimes it's more subtle than that. Sometimes it's sort of this self-promoting comment and then a degradation comment about another person. Tell me how many times you've experienced this. You come out of a meeting or you're talking about someone working on a project or in another organization or some initiative that some organization has, and the person says, well, if it were me, I would have done it differently. I would have done it like this, this, and this. And then there's a follow-on comment about the leader or the organization, some degrading comment like, they really don't have all the information they need to succeed, or they really aren't well informed to be making this decision. It's a self-promoting comment coupled with a degradation comment. That is so common, and that is a competitive comment, believe it or not. That is meant to level the playing field. It's meant to have the person who's saying it rise up in the scale of being while knocking down someone else. And that is a very competitive behavior that once you recognize it, and if you feel comfortable, you can call it out and say something about it. There's a number of ways that you can address that if you so choose. One of the ways that I like to address it is just to pose a question. You know, I noticed in that meeting that you were really, really critical of so-and-so's project or idea. It really came across as though you were trying to sort of knock them out of play. Was that your intention? And see how they respond. Because if it wasn't their intention, perhaps you've just articulated to them something they didn't even know they did that was more instinctual rather than well thought out. And you can help them start to get to the next level. Another way to do it that maybe is a little less direct is to just be suggestive. And if you yourself have come out in support of something that's worthy of support for another woman in a meeting, and yet there are other people that didn't, you can refer back to that and say, you know, I'm supporting this for these reasons and because I think it's so important that when I can back up projects, when I can get behind them, that I share that openly because I want all women to succeed as much as I want myself to succeed, because when we don't all work together, we actually harm each other. And start to talk in those terms and see if you can influence some change in your workplace or your professional setting by being that kind of person that actually sort of says the emperor has no clothes, calls out a little bit, either gently or more directly or subtly, about the competitive behavior that you see going on in the professional environment. I think one of the things that's so important is to point out the destructive nature of competitive behavior. And when we can articulate that to other women, and the consequences of when we don't support each other, even just asking them how they think men see women who are competing with each other, when there's that subtle catfight, that judgmental self-promoting comment, and then that judgmental or degradation comment about someone else. If you make people aware of that and then ask them, hey, how do you think men are perceiving us here? Because I will tell you that no man wants to get in the middle of a cat fight, okay? And let's say both of you are up for a promotion or up for an award or just trying to build a relationship with this person. I can tell you from experience and from having great relationships with a lot of professional men, there aren't many of them that want to get in the middle of that catfight. They'll avoid it. And what that means is they'll avoid both of you, both the one who is being catty and the one who's being attacked. So again, we go back to all ships rise or all ships sink. All ships rise in an abundance mindset. All ships sink in a scarcity mindset. And what we want to do is stop competing with each other and start helping each other succeed and then go for our personal best. The last thing I would say is share your intention to build a movement in a community of women supporting women. It doesn't really matter how you say it, but just talking about how when you support a woman, why you did it, and just say, you know, something along the lines of, you know, I've been really thinking about how I can support some other women on the team, and I'm hoping that I can have a dialogue with you about it, and maybe you can tell me how you can see some opportunities to support other women in the team, and maybe that way we can start to create this movement in our work environment that helps all of us succeed. Just share what you're about. Share that this is important to you, and you'll start to build a community around you. It may not happen right away. This is not something that you typically see in the workplace. It's not something that there's a broad movement towards, and it's not even very intuitive. So it takes some time, but go ahead and just start, because the more you surround people with leadership, the more you start to influence them to adopt those leadership characteristics themselves. So I hope this is helpful to you in learning why it is that women compete and why it's so important that we try to mitigate that and try to move forward supporting each other, of course, supporting worthy women. We don't just support any woman, because we know that just as with men and with women, there's always people that maybe don't have the level of character and honesty and integrity that we would want to support, or there might be other circumstances as well regarding competencies or whatever, and it's really important to always be honest about those things in yourself. But where support is merited and where there's potential for good, it's really important to get behind that with each other and build a community of women supporting women. So I hope you go out there and have a great week. It's been fun talking to you this week, and I look forward to seeing you next time.